I'd now like to invite Ms. Anu Gupta from the FIT, our partner, to say a few words. Anu is the deputy head of the private sector at and is responsible for a range of new projects, including the Poorer States Inclusive Growth Project, also known as Samriddhi Impact Investing Program. Diverse range, Anu, over to you.
We've been working with Vineet and his team for some time, and last year or earlier this year, we sponsored. I'd like to take a few moments to just to say, give a quick overview of DFIT and our private sector program. I need not repeat, Richard and Mr. Sinha have both laid down the context very well about the 8 income states and the relevance of working on development and growth opportunities here. DFID partnership in India, which is DFID for those of you who may not know, is the UK aid government, a bilateral aid program. We have a long-standing historical and evolving relationship with India. Our 5 key partners include Government of India, where we support on national programs, the state governments, and currently we have 3 partner-focused states, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, and Odisha, multilateral and bilateral donors such as GIZ and World Bank, civil society and private sector. Since we are in Patna today, it will be appropriate for me just to mention very briefly that we have a suite of programs with a commitment of over 200 million in sectors such as health, water, sanitation, urban development, all working towards with partnership to bring about better results for the poor. So one of the common themes for all our programs is to look at transparency, value for money and results in whatever work we do. And now moving on to private sector development work. Private sector development work is new to us. New in the sense that we have traditionally been working with the state governments or the national governments on a very much grant-based approach. So since last year, it's the first time we actually brought about a new horizon to our work, where we thought we should capitalize on the energy and enthusiasm of private sector. So our approach and objective is basically to work along with private sector, but all our aims are towards the benefits of the poor and underprivileged. Poor and underprivileged, how would they benefit? Either as producers, consumers, or income. Now, why are we in this space is often a question a lot of people ask us. The DFID additionality, as I like to call it, is basically our primary mandate is development. We are looking at improved and enhanced products, services, jobs, incomes, and assets, all leading to improved quality of life. Financial, as many of us said, this is not about grants, this is about commercial viability, scale, and sustainability. And last but not the least, and perhaps the most important role that we play is demonstration. Supporting new geographies, new partnerships, ability to take risks, provide patient risk capital, new mechanisms of incentives, and overarching and new pioneering environmental and social governance systems. We have 3 strands in our approach, and I'll talk very briefly. This is just to give a flavor of the kind of work we plan to do under private sector. 3 areas, policy work, and examples of that are investment climate work, which we are doing, for example, with Government of Bihar under our governance and administrative reforms. The work around incubation and incubate system building. Private investment is simply providing investment, so Samriddhi Fund, which Mr. Sharma will talk over after this, is an example. Other 2 new areas which we will work closely is affordable housing with National Housing Bank and infrastructure with a range of infrastructure providers. And we of course have a few programs which are directly targeted to poor, such as the SIDBI's program with microfinance, and we're looking at opportunities to work in the area of skills as well. But not the least, I'd just like to say why the Samriddhi Sankalp Summit is for us. It's a very special event and a very special occasion for us. It's not about just opportunities, it's not about just promoting people and identifying a platform where we are not looking at just opportunities, but helping and promote and overcoming the barriers and challenges. For us, it's about deepening our links with the private sector and recognizing innovations and rewarding them.